talking of employees, how do you zero down on the people that you employ here, and how many are there?
Yes. Now, we started with two medical officers, and we started with four nurses. We started with the two radiologists to do the scan, because at that time we didn't have the X-ray running, and we also had fire cleaners. That was my entire staff. But as time went on, I found that the nurses were working day and night, which was not good. They would feel tired, sleepy. So adding two nurses, so we have now six nurses on the ground. And the doctors, I still have the other two primary doctors that I started with, but then we have added other four specialists who come here for these specialist clinics. We have a physician who comes here every Friday. We have a gynecologist who comes here. We have an orthopedic surgeon, and we have a pediatrician. So those are my team. They're not permanent employees. I pay them per patient when they come here, so that I could reduce on the burden of salaries. Yes, so that's the stuff I have. I fear I should add more, but still, I fear we can be working with this for a meantime, 2-3 months to come, and we'll see how it grows. Maybe I can think about adding more staffs.
Dr. Simon, the experience is so, let me say, it's great to work with Dr. Simon because he's experienced enough, and I've got a lot of experience in this place. The lab is well equipped with machines. We have CBC. CBC machine, it's good machine. It can tell all about your body defense mechanisms, because there is what you call lymphocytes, monocytes. Those are all about the body defense mechanisms, which doctor can follow up to make a final diagnosis. HB estimation, that's the level of blood you have in your body, can also do. We have RFT machine, but it's now out of the place, but soon they're going to bring it. Just going for that pair that is there.
So tell us, what kind of services do you offer to people in this medical center?
We offer a broad range of services. We offer both inpatient and outpatient services. We have about 15 beds. We have 15 beds in this facility. And so, like I said, both inpatient and outpatient, we do both generalized and specialized services like ENT, ophthalmology, dental, skin, all those clinics which we are running, orthopedics. And those, so that's the specialized bit of it. We also have dental services like you've seen, root canal treatments, scaling and polishing, all those dentures, so that's our dental unit. And we do antenatal and maternity services. So we do antenatal, we give flows cards, we follow up mothers, and they deliver from here because we have a maternity. Then we also started our theater, so we are doing major operations. I have a surgeon who comes here to operate. Of course, we also have a gynecologist on board, so we can do both major operations. We've not started doing orthopedic operations, but we shall do them as we step up. So that is the surgeries department. We also do things like family planning, HIV, and TB care. We have a laboratory, so people can come here and do most of these tests. Yes, we have sexual partnerships with top laboratories in Kampala, so we can now do most of the tests for blood and everything. We invested money in our radiology department. So we do X-rays now for bones, you know, HSG for those tubes, see if they are patent for females. We do barium enemas, that's X-ray. Then we do scans, ultrasound scan, most of the tests. And we also do ECG, this test for imaging for the heart. It's in the machine there in my office, so we do ECG. Those are some of the things we are offering. And many more, of course, general medicine, pediatrics, and all those areas that we are offering services in. So there are some of the services we offer. We also do, we try to do the thing of online, like emergency kind of thing. People call us online and trying to link them to the specialists and other clinics and that kind of stuff. Yes, so it's an area that needs investment in, but we are just starting up, you know, online consultancy, that department. We've applied to insurance companies, like top 6 insurance companies around Kampala. they have approved, but we still have to negotiate with them when to start offering the services. When we started, I didn't think we had the capacity to run insurance companies because these guys pay after 3-4 months. So I just feel like it is now getting to time when I can start offering services because I needed daily cash flow of money. So we're about to start offering these services for insurers. But we have our own scheme, our own patients who have been using our own insurance scheme. We are giving services. So those are some of the services we are offering and of course we need.
So what challenges have you gone through to actually maintain and manage this medical center?
The challenge is, when we started this whole clinic, the challenges, among the major challenges we've been facing, which has been real over time, is the challenge of our economy affects us so much. The way you see the economy outside there, as other businesses battle with the economy, also battle with them. Because we buy these drugs, we sign the contract with pharmacies, we supply us drugs. Now prices change because of the dollar fluctuation, because of our economy, and that affects us. Because we have prices, and now when drugs have gone high, it is hard to tell your daily customers that the drugs have gone high, so I'm increasing this. So we face that challenge. We also have a challenge of time. I feel like I don't get enough time to talk to my parents, follow them up, see how they are doing, how they are, give them home visits. Those are some of the things that I would like to do, but which unfortunately I don't really get time to do. And there is a big issue of litigation. Private medical practice is now a target for most lawyers around town. You have to ensure that whatever you do meets, you have to be professional and you have to meet international standards of doing things. I see very many patients who walk in here and they want to fake an HIV test. They say, doctor, can we fake an HIV test? Which we refuse, of course. So those are some of the things that we face at the moment, which are a big challenge to us. People misuse drugs. You get very many clients who have gone to pharmacies, had their own prescription. So if
when
they
it
come,
fails, they
when
come
it fails, they come here and they find this guy has used a whole chunk of antibiotics in the whole pharmacy. It's not getting better. So there's what we call antibiotics resistance. It's something that has come up and, you know, we didn't expect it, but it is really a big challenge to us. Sometimes we give the best antibiotics for most common infections, and these guys take so long, we have to use very expensive medication to achieve the same results like a lot of people if they didn't have the antibiotic resistance. So it's one of the challenges we face. Of course, I'm indebted. This clinic is heavily indebted, but I'm paying the debts. So I feel like I need more capital, but right now I'm like, let me concentrate on what we have. It's a challenge we have. Sometimes we get a little bit overwhelmed by the people we get, but we feel we shall get there. There are some of the challenges we have.
So what advice do you give to the youth, especially people in your age bracket who are still waiting for maybe appointment letters, who feel like I cannot have my own business, I need a lot of capital? Just give them a few of the tips that have actually helped you pull through.
Yeah. I think the whole point begins with you having a vision. You have to know where you want to be. And when you know where you want to be, you have to forge means of trying to get there. It takes a lot of things, it takes a lot of stumbling blocks, and you need to really don't give up on your dream, no matter how hard it takes. I failed in a lot of businesses, and even now I cannot tell you that I'm very successful. I can't say I'm successful, but I feel like I'm on track to get where I want to be in the next 30 or 40 years. Yes, so you really have to know where you want to be, work hard, you have to stay focused, you have to get a mentor who helps you, you know, get through all those things. Yes, I have very many mentors, guys who have helped me, where I go and I learn a lot of things. And you have to be open to learning. Business needs a lot of, you know, learning. Taking up, it needs a lot of, you have to learn very many things. So you keep learning, I keep reading every day. It's a process to keep working. And even when you start something, I think it is imperative that you try to go in an area where you have some knowledge. So if you identify where you want to be, get to know it, learn about something you want to start to do. And when you start doing it, give it your best. your best, you make sure you concentrate a lot. You concentrate without getting tired. So it helps you a lot. And you know, you keep reading things, you keep following up, you keep following someone's example. It helps you to get there. And it needs a lot of patience. At times I've had to go sleep on an empty stomach because when I paid for this X-ray, the first post, I didn't have supper. I had no money to lose. I had invested everything I had. I was indebted. I didn't have supper. So it takes a lot of sacrifice, really. It takes a lot of patience to get there where you want to get. So it's one of the things. But still, I have to say that at the end of the day, it all goes back to like business. Yes, because I feel like I need to take a path for business completely.
So what are your future plans? What should we expect of Simon maybe in the next few years?
It's a lot of things that I would want to achieve. First of all, I would want to reach to as many people around the Chengera as I can. Not only Chengera actually, but in this Wakiso, Kampala, and the surrounding districts as I can. We want to be the best in providing medical services. Yes, we want to be the best. We want to be a place where people can rely on us. You know, people where they can come and they find everything. CT scan, MRI, a very standard maternity, you know, that kind of thing. You know, where people come here for the whole complete thing. Yes, but I told you, like, my dream is not to remain this small. I want to be bigger than, case bigger than those Novica and BB. I want to be like the top brand in East Africa, to be like the best. But I know it will take me some time, but I know I will get there if I keep working hard and going being on my head and my side.
Thanks for allowing us to have you and for sharing so much insightful information to the people that are watching. Well, we come to the end of today's episode of Legit Hustler, and I wouldn't want to water down what he has said, but from what I've gotten, it is be aggressive, never give up, even through the failures. Get up and do what you have to do. My name is Brenda Kimbabazi. Have yourselves a good evening and see you again next week.